Stepper! Stepper, come! Stepper, come. Come on, let's work.
Hi, everyone. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper Dog, and we're just trying to remind you not to put your hearts away just yet, because there's still some use for these heart punches. Let's get busy. You know, the hardest part about this card is how to finish it off. I mean, you could put a white ribbon here. The center could be white. The center could be glitzy. And we'll even show you how to use a different color ribbon down here. And so you finish it off which way looks good to you. For this project, we're not only going to need the full heart punch, but the 1 3/4 inch punch and the 1 inch circle punch. And this nice little single stamp for Happy St. Patrick's Day that's in the Occasions 2011 mini. We're going to start off with some Garden Green and Whisper White cardstock. And I'm going to stamp that in the center. And then I'm going to take this bit of Wild Wasabi. As you can tell, it's just a scrap. And I don't even need to stamp the full stamp on there, just to make sure that I have this center bit. This is a very quick card to recreate. With the 1 3/4 inch circle punch, I'm gonna get the stamp centered as best I can. And the same with the 1 inch and the center. Isn't it funny how we tend to be really quiet when we're trying to get something right smack dab in the middle? All that matters is that I don't pick up any of this when I'm getting that center part out. So now we're going to get it together, and I'm going to start with a Garden Green base, Whisper White around the edge. Now for me, some people like to put snail all the way around. Some people think a little dab will do you. I'm one of these people that will meet you halfway, and I like to go across the 2 short edges and then a little bit on either side. I've cut this a little bit differently than the sample, so let's see how it's going to turn out. The borders are a little bit wider to bring a little bit more of the Garden Green into play. Snail, love it. However, when it comes time to go and put these textured items on, and this is the Perfect Polka Dots with the Big Shot, it seems like I can't do a card without it. Well, I could, but it wouldn't be as much fun. Just have to use that Big Shot. Oh, wow. Now that is too much. Honestly, I do not like glue. Glue is just a mess usually, but this Tombow Mono Multi is perfect. All I need is a little bit around the edge, and then I just kind of bring it in a little bit. I'm not putting any more on at this point. I'm just spreading it around a little bit better. But anyway, if you just really scritch a little bit on, that's a technical term, you don't really need a lot. And it holds really well. It's very strong. And you can shift it a little. There we go. So let's put our focal piece together. I've already punched out a couple of our hearts, but I want to show you how this last heart goes. I not only want to punch it out right here, but I'm also going to just shift it in just a little bit. Hope you can see that. And now you know how I got, my stem. I'm just putting a little itty bitty dot to hold the tail down, or the, not the tail, but the stem down. And that's just to hold the bottom part in, and then I'm going to put a dimensional there, and I'm going to put dimensionals on all the back of my hearts. And because this is kind of a heavy piece, I've got one right there too. Now if you ever have problems getting your coverings off, try just piercing them with your thumbnail. Don't have to have a big thumbnail. Real thumbnails work. And now I've got to put that down so the two dimensionals don't meet. The one on the back here in the middle and the one that I put at the top of the stem. And that's pretty much like right. Stick this on the back. Doesn't have to go exactly the same way. You could shift it if you want to. It's your card. Now I'm going to show you how I did this bow, and I thought it might be a little bit easier to see if I do it with some Peach Parfait ribbon. Might be easier for you to see. All I did, I just took this and tied a little half of a knot. And if you do this while it's still on the bolt, you'll use less ribbon, which is great when you're doing a lot. Like, let's say you're doing a lot of party invitations. See? And then you pick which side you like best. Get your mini glue dot. And I don't know if this is politically correct to have an orange one on here. But you can put the orange one on, or you can put the white one on. Or why don't you put any color you like and let me know how it works for you. This is Ann Clemmer and Stamper Dog from stamperdog.com, bringing little paper and ink to your day.